the revised syllabus with you? Ramina, Nitin, good morning. Kritika, do you have revised syllabus with you? Chemistry syllabus revised one? Yes. Very soon take the syllabus and check what topics are there for your portions. Please do it fastly. Take unit 15 and check what topics, type and send me the topics immediately. What topics are there in your portions?
Dozen, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Please start your session, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, children. Other children can listen. Children, I want to make a small correction. So when I taught you about graphene, I changed the scientist name. It is not Harry and it's not Harry and Robert Curl. It is Kostya Novoselov. Kostya Novoselov and Andrei Gem. See, these two scientists only, they discovered graphene. They discovered graphene. The structure of graphene is a hexagonal ring with one carbon atom. Okay, a hexagon ring with one carbon atom. It is a single layer of carbon atom. It is graphene. Okay, this Kostya Novoselov and Andrei Gem, they discovered graphene is also a carbon compound. Okay, what they found out is when this graphene, one molecule of graphene, okay, when many molecules of graphene were combined like this, okay, when many molecules of graphene was kept one above the other, they got graphite. They got graphite. It is also an allotrope of carbon. I will say what is allotrope. Don't confuse. It is a compound. Graphite is a carbon compound. Okay. So graphene, only one single molecule. This one structure alone is graphene. Okay. When graphene is kept one above the other, when they are united, it forms graphite. Okay. So it was done by Kostya Novoselov and Andrei Gem. Okay. Then what did Harry and his colleagues made, Robert Curl and Richard, what do they found out, you know? They found out a new carbon compound called fullerene. They found out, have you come across this name fullerene? It is new, no? Yes, it's a new carbon compound. Yes, very good, Nitin, you are correct. Yes, Nitin, that's what I want. So, Lavoisier is a scientist who discovered oxygen. Okay, the most famous discovery of Lavoisier is the invention of the discovery of oxygen. It is a life-saving gas and so on. He was the first scientist to discover oxygen, carbon, nitrogen. Very good, Nitin. Yes. So, fullerene is also a carbon compound discovered by three scientists. Okay, so who are they? Robert, Richard, as well as Harry. Okay, so Robert Curl, Richard Smalley, and Harry Kroto. These are three scientists who discovered fullerene. So what is particular about fullerene, you know, so far you have seen that carbon comes only in the hexagon shape. The atoms are arranged hexagon shape. Here, in this fullerene, the carbon atoms are arranged like a soccer ball, like a football, like this. Okay, so this is a special feature of fullerene. Here, the carbon atoms are arranged like a soccer ball. Clear? Yes, children, so it is not the form of hexagon, not the form of ring, not the form of branch chains, the form of soccer ball. This is fullerene. Yes, clear, children? Now we can pass on to the unique features of carbon. What made carbon so special? Okay. Now, we have under this carbon, no, we came across carbon monoxide first, okay? And there are a few carbon compounds which has some importance in this environment. That is carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, calcium carbide, calcium carbonate. Okay, these are the few forms of carbon which are found in nature. See, carbon monoxide alone is not natural. It is formed due to the incomplete combustion of fossil fuel, but all the other forms are present in the nature. Okay, so sodium bicarbonate, calcium carbonate, calcium bicarbonate, calcium carbide, carbon disulfide. These are all the few carbon compounds which are found in nature in our earth crust. Okay, so what are the properties? You know, we have few peculiar properties of carbon, okay, which makes it so abundantly distributed in this world. What is that first compound? First property is tetravalency. Then catenation. All these terms are new to you, children. Don't worry, I'll explain to you in detail. Okay, catenation. Then multiple bond. And fourth one is allotropy. These are the four important properties of carbon which makes it so widely distributed all through this world. In each and every substance has carbon because of this four property only. Okay, so tetravalency, catenation, multiple bonding, and one more one, isomerism. So five properties are there. It's very important to remember always. Okay, so carbon has five important properties which makes it so widely distributed all over the world in each and every compound. What are they? Tetravalency, catenation, multiple bonding, allotropy, and isomerism. Clear? So I'll explain to you each and every concept, whether it is in your portion or not, but just you know what is that. Clear? So first you can talk about tetravalency. Okay, I think sir has taught you about periodic table, isn't it? I think you know about periodic table. Okay, so if you have concentrated, listened well the periodic table, surely you'll be knowing what is valency. What is valency? What is orbit? I think you know what is orbit. Do you know what is orbit? What is valency? Children, please answer my question. Do you know what is valency? Do you know what is atomic number? Atomic number, atomic mass, okay. So Remina, Kavya have answered, they know about valency. Yes, so you know what is atomic number and atomic mass, isn't it? Okay, now can you tell me the atomic number of carbon? What is atomic number of carbon? What happened, children? Nobody is answering. Six. Are you sure? Carbon number is six only? Okay, very good. Okay. Can you name the shells of an orbit? How many shells are there? Can you name the shells? Can you name the shells? How many shells are there? only two are there. What are they? What are they? K and L. Okay. What are subshells present? What are the subshells? Name the subshells. Have you come across? Yes, P, D, F shells. Yes, P, D, F. Have you come across these shells, subshells? S shell, P shell, D subshell, and F subshell. Have you come across this? Okay, no problem. See, each element has a nucleus, isn't it? Then it has an orbit. Clear? The orbit has subshells, isn't it? So, in what arrangement they will be? So, each subshell can have only a particular number of electrons in it. Clear? For example, S shell can hold only two electrons. S shell can hold only two electrons. So, each element has a nucleus. In the nucleus, you can see. So, each element has three substances, isn't it? Protons are there, neutrons are there, and electrons are there. You know that? You know that? Each and every element will be having three important substances. That is proton, neutron, and electron. Okay. The nucleus will be having proton and neutron. The electrons will be orbiting around the nucleus. Isn't it? That's what you learned in periodic table. Isn't it? The electrons will be orbiting around the nucleus. Clear? The number of protons will be equal number of electrons. Am I correct? The number of protons will be equal to number of electrons. Am I correct? Sure. Then what about neutrons? What about neutrons? Children, what about neutrons? Okay, I want you to all go through the periodic table once again today. Clear, children? After the class is over, see, periodic table has many components in 10th standard also. Clear? So, kindly, after the class is over, sit in a place, go through the periodic table, each and every aspect. If you have any doubt regarding the periodic table, come and ask me tomorrow. Clear? Okay, come to this tetravalency. As you told, carbon has six, atomic number is six. Okay, so it should have only six electron. Clear? So the atomic number is equal to its electron. It has six electron. Okay, so it has two electron in the innermost shell and four electron in the outer shell. See here, like this. See. Clear? So, the valency, what is valency? You know, the number of free electrons present in the outermost shell is called its valency. Clear? The number of free electrons present in the outermost shell is the valency of that particular element. Now, what is the valency of carbon? Can anybody say? I have given a definition for valency. The number of electrons present in the outermost. Very good, Annie. The valency of carbon is 4. Clear? What is the valency of carbon now? It is 4. That's what it's called as tetravalency. Tetra means 4. Clear? So carbon has, the valency of carbon is 4. Clear? Now what happens now? Since it has 4 free electrons in the outermost shell, see here, it has 4 electrons in the outermost shell. Okay, these electrons can bind with any other element. For example, you take oxygen. Clear? So the carbon can bind, has 4 electrons. No, carbon can bind very well with oxygen. Clear? See, it has 4 electrons to bind. Clear? That's what carbon forms many compounds with other, with when it combine with other elements and form many compounds. That's what we have, lot of carbon compounds, because it's tetravalency nature. See, this will bond with one atom, this will bond with another atom, this will bond with one atom, this will bond with one atom. See how? Okay, so it can bond with the other elements. It can, what is bond? It is a connection between two elements. Bond is nothing but a connection between two elements. So it has 4 valency, you know. So it can bond easily with other elements and form various kinds of compounds. Here's the first property. Second one is catenation. So what is catenation? Wait a minute. Okay. Catenation. So what is catenation? So because of this tetravalence, you know, it is nothing but a property of an element to bind with the other element. What is catenation? The property of an element. So see, carbon to bind with other element. It may be oxygen. Okay, it may be sulfur. It may be calcium. Okay, see, carbon dioxide, carbon disulfide, calcium carbonate. Okay, it is a property of an the property of an element to bind with other element. It's called as catenation. Okay, how it will bind other element? Using the bond. Okay, using the bond. So various kinds of bonds are there. See, covalent bond is there, covalent bond is there, electrovalent bond is there. Okay, covalent bond, electrovalent bond, and that is in covalent itself you have single bond, double bond, triple bond. Okay, so using these various kinds of bonds, that's what we have: diamond, we have charcoal, we have coal. Okay, they are purely carbon compounds. Clear? Carbon, charcoal, diamond, graphite, coal are purely carbon compound. See, one atom of carbon can combine with another atom of carbon. It has 4 valency, you know. See here, like this. Now it forms one compound. Clear? Otherwise, it combines with oxygen here, carbon here, sulfur here. Okay, like that. So because it has 4 bonds, it can combine to its atom itself or with the other elements also. That is called as catenation. Clear, children? Then what is the next property? Third property is multiple bonding. Again, the same thing only. Multiple bonding. That is, as I told you earlier, it can bond with covalent bond, electrovalent bond. There may be single bond, see, single bond like this, or it can be a double bond like this, or it can be a triple bond like this. Clear? It can bind with single bond, double bond, or triple bond. Depending upon the type of bond, the property will vary. Okay, if it is single bond, that compound can be easily isolated, easily separated. Only one bond is there, no? So when it is heated or when it combines with any other, easily the bond will go off. Clear? It can combine with any other. See, this bond between carbon will go off and it can bond easily with oxygen. A single bond is there. Double bond, the reaction takes little more intense. Okay. The double bond is very thick, no? You cannot easily dissolve the bond. Okay, bond nothing but a connection. Okay, double bond is, it takes some severe practice, that is strong heating, adding some extra chemicals, or is needed. Triple bond is still more harder. the bond is very strong. They cannot be separated so easily. Okay, so depending upon the presence of single, double, triple, or covalent or electrovalent, the property of the compound will be changing. Clear? Okay. See, if a single bond, very easily they can be dissociated. Double bond takes little more effort. Triple bond takes very intense effort to break the bonds. Clear, children? Any doubts you have? Clear doubts then and there? Now, the important aspect is here, nothing but isomerism. See, what is isomerism? It is a property that is same molecular formula will be there. That is, listen carefully, same molecular formula will be there. The molecular formula of a compound will be same. Okay, see, for example, C4H10 is called as butane. C4H10. Okay, here, see, it has 4 carbon atom and 10 hydrogen atom. Okay, same molecular formula, but they differ in the structural arrangement. They differ in the structural arrangement. Clear? So what is this? Same molecular formula, but different structural formula is called as isomerism. Okay, so what do you mean by that? See, the C4H10. How can we write this? For example, see here, CH2, one bond, CH3, again one bond, CH3, one bond, CH2. It is one form of writing. This is one compound, one arrangement. This is one arrangement. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon atoms are there. 2 plus 3, 5, 8, 10 carbon atoms are there. This is one arrangement. Clear? Now, same arrangement, see, same thing can write in another way. That is CH3, one bond, CH3, another bond, CH3. So one more CH is remaining, no? That CH occupies this position, CH. See, the same carbon, since it has 4 valency, okay, see, the valency of carbon is 4, no? So this carbon combines with this compound and then this group, CH3 group, and this C again combines with CH group. This is one arrangement. Okay, so what is this arrangement called? This arrangement is called as ether. Okay, this arrangement is called as ether. Okay, so they have left one thing, ether. They have left one thing, C4. So this is ether and this is ester. Only one difference. Clear? This is what this is called as this same structural formula only, C4H10 only. But see the arrangement. This is a chain arrangement. Here, each carbon combines with hydrogen atom. Here, see, this carbon combines with hydrogen molecule. This carbon combines with hydrogen. But see here, this carbon combines with hydrogen on one side and CH group on another side. CH3 on one side, CH on other side. Okay, this is called isomerism. Same molecular formula will be there, but the structural arrangement will be different. This is called as isomerism. Any doubts, children? Any doubts? See, they will be having different chemical as well as physical properties. Though they have same molecular formula, their chemical property and physical property will be different. So what is physical property and this chemical property? Can anybody say what is physical property? Give one or two examples for physical property. Yes, children. Give physical property. When you're learning new terms, you should first understand what is that. what the physical property is nothing but the appearance. Okay, physical property means the appearance. Okay, what, how do they taste? What is the color? What is the order they give? Okay, what form they are, in the powder form or in the solid form, the crystal form, the gaseous form. Okay, then they smell sweet, they smell bitter. Okay, they taste sweet, like that. That is a physical property. Okay, so what's a chemical property? Chemical property is nothing but how do they react with other elements. Clear? So physical property is the appearance of, for example, when I say what is the physical property of an apple, what do you say? I am asking you, what is the physical property of an apple? What you will say? Yes, children? Red. Very good. Okay. Okay. Any other physical property you noted? Any other physical property? You can say about the shape. Whenever we see something, we used to say this, the shape of an apple. It has a peculiar shape, no? Shape, color. See, you cannot. Yes, lustrous. Very good, Divya. But Divya, it is naturally, it is not lustrous, Divya. Naturally, apple is not lustrous. They apply a lot of wax and oil to attract us. Yes, yes, Divya. Very good. Yes. Now, you know the different physical and chemical property. Chemical property, the property of an element to react with other elements. How it reacts with water, how it reacts with salt, how it reacts with acid, how it reacts with base. Clear? How it reacts with metals, non-metals. That is a chemical property. Okay? Though it has the same molecular formula, it differs both in, it has different physical as well as different chemical properties. Do you understand this? Okay, so one more property is there, that's allotropy. I think it needs some more time to complete it. Okay, children, I asked you about the deleted portions now in this lesson. Is anybody is ready with the deleted portions, children? See, in carbon compounds, what portion is deleted? Just mention the number alone. Allotropy is not in the portion. Okay. Harini, just give me the number alone. 15.3, like that. 15.5, which is included alone, you give me. Allotropy is not in the portion. Okay, fine. Children, so far, do you have any doubt regarding this? Tetravalency, catenation, multiple bond, isomerism. Do you have any doubt? If you have doubt, kindly clear here, because in 10th standard, you will come across many carbon compounds. Okay? So, do you know what is hydrocarbon? Have you come across this term hydrocarbon? What is hydrocarbon? It's nothing but compounds which contain only hydrogen and carbon. It is called as hydrocarbon. No other element will be there. Oxygen will not be there. Sulfur will not be there. Nitrogen, calcium, nothing. Only hydrogen and carbon will be there. They are called as hydrocarbons. A very good example is coal, petrol. But all petroleum products are hydrocarbons only. Okay, charcoal, they all are hydrocarbons only. Aldehyde, okay, they are, aldehydes are not carbon, hydrocarbons. See, petroleum products few carbon compounds are hydrocarbons where only hydrogen and carbon are present. Clear, children? Yes, ma'am, how many minutes or more, ma'am?
Time is up, ma'am.
Time is up. Okay, ma'am. Okay. Yes, children, can see the from it is included, Harini. Harini, can kindly send me again. I'll note it down immediately.